Good evening, everyone. Let us pray. Pray natin yung Father. Ano mo first name?
Roberto.
Yeah, let us pray. Father, we thank you for this evening. We lift up Mr. Roberto Ong, Panginoon, and we pray for your divine healing upon him. We believe your best, Panginoon. We believe that by the stripes of Jesus, he was and he is healed. Inihiling namin, Panginoon, for good results. The test gagawin, Panginoon. And we just pray that you would strengthen his faith. And also that the family would be encouraged and strengthened. And even at this moment, Panginoon. Father, tonight, as we study your word, we pray for your guidance and direction sa aming lahat. We thank you for this new series. Namin tatalakayan. We ask for your will to be done in all of this. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Good evening po sa inyong lahat. Isn't God good?
Amen.
Amen. Just a quick testimony. Yung pong prayer box natin, some of you don't know, bago po nag-start yung prayer box, merong nag-initiate na isang member natin. Every service, be it Wednesday or Sunday, naglalagay po siya ng prayer request sa instead of the box, the offering box. Kasi wala naman ibang paglalagyan. And yung pinagpipray niya yung asawa niya to submit to God yung asawa niya. And every service talaga, pag kinokollecting offering, meron piece of paper. And after, hindi ko alam gaano katagal, sobrang tagal po, maybe a year or more, pray siya. And now, umate na yung asawa niya. And they are, talaga nakita mo yung answered prayer. So, mga kapatid, huwag natin maliitin, these things that we do, the prayers in a box. Seems like a very trivial thing to do. Pero hindi po, God answers prayers. And He does see the effort, yung faith. Sabi nga ni Pastor Jesse couple of Sundays ago, sabi niya that we have faith the size of a mustard seed. So ibig sabihin, ang liit na effort na kailangan just to show God that we trust in Him. We put our trust in Him. Amen. For the coming year, 2017, actually, kaming mga pastors, we've been praying regarding reaching out more. Makabot tayo mas lalo. And we have been making small efforts. The women of the church, sila po yung pupunta sa mga bars and ministering to bar girls and employees in the bars. This happens once a month. Tapos kaming mga lalaki, we went to the school para mag-reach out to the school and mga street people. These are just small things we are doing, pero we are still praying that God would open doors for us to be able to minister on a more permanent basis. And this year, this coming year, magkakaroon po tayo ng, if you don't know, yung mga drug pushers and drug users, yung mga surrenderies during the administration of ating presidente, they're very close to a million now, over 800,000 that surrender. And what's so amazing about this is tayo po as a church, nationwide, the church has been praying for change in the nation. Karon ng pagbabago, na kumilos ang Diyos. And the national government approached the church para gumawa ng way how to reach out to these men and women. So, under the pangunguna po ng CEF, CCF, Christ Commission Foundation, sila po ay nag-come up with a 12-week or 12-session module kung saan it reaches out to the family and the drug dependent and the drug pusher. Tapos, this church, tayo po, we have the opportunity to be a part of that. Ito po ay gaganapin sa 164. There are over 1,600 inmates, kasama lalaki at babae. So
with 12 sessions per 150 people, it will take us 6 months just to cover the 150 people. And then, baka umabot ng 5 to 6 years para tapusin yung 1,600 inmates. So we have a lot of work para to do. Pero it's an honor kasi gagamitin tayo ng Diyos to bring change to this nation. And, you know, so the reason why I'm announcing this kasi we will be needing, starting next month, we will need anywhere from 20 to 30 volunteers from the church, which can commit to 2 days within the 6 months. Hindi naman natin kailangan i-cover in 6 months, as long as we're just apart. At the moment, we're looking at 2 days and 6 months, only 2 days to be a part of this. So it might be more, hindi ko po alam, we're still working out the details. But if you want to be part of this, please do pray about this. Yung 2 days na po yan, it'll be a Tuesday and a Thursday, and it'll only be 2 hours a day. So in 1 month, 2 days in 1 month, and 2 hours, so a total of 4 hours of your life that may change the life of one man or even his family. So think about that, pray about that. Napaka, it really, don't think na isipin nyo na hindi natin kaya. Because it's really not us, hindi naman talaga tayo ang magbabago ng tao. So don't put so much pressure on yourself na hindi ko kaya. We're putting our trust in God. Tayo po ay nagtitiwala sa Diyos. So please do pray about this. Hindi ako masyadong maraming details na pwedeng i-share sa inyo kasi hindi pa naman malinis na malinis, although it's already planned out for the next 6 months starting January. Pero yung mga details, the orientation will be held here next month. Meron pong, I think, 2 or 3 hour orientation will be held here. And if you want to be part of it, both male and female pwede kasi there are also female inmates doon sa 164. So yun lamang po announcement regarding that. So tonight we begin our new topic, parables, short stories, eternal results. There are over 50 parables that Jesus taught. So some of which pinagdidipatihan pa, some, you know, some Bible scholars are still not agreeing as to whether they're parables or not. So there's not an exact amount of how many, but there are over 50. So that says we have about a year to study the parables, because 52 weeks. So about a year to study the parables or even more. The parable is, by definition, is a short allegorical story designed to illustrate or teach some truth, religious principle, or moral lesson. Allegories are like the truth is hidden, or the story or the meaning is hidden. You have to search, or kailangan hukayin mo maigi para maintindihan. Number two, it's a statement or a comment that conveys a meaning indirectly by the use of comparison, analogy, or the likes. So the parables of Jesus, you'll notice, ito po ay introduction pa lamang. Next Wednesday, we'll start on the first parable. Pero if you notice, when you read a parable, like let's say the parable of the sower, there's a meaning, pero hindi ka agad naiintindihan, you know. And there's a reason for this, and we'll discuss this tonight. There's a reason for all of that. Matthew chapter 13, verse 10. Then the disciples came to him and said, "Why do you speak to them in parables?" So there are five reasons. There are several reasons, actually. Pero tonight, let's discuss five reasons why Jesus taught in parables. Number one, to give his enemies no ground. So we'll understand this in a moment. The enemies of Jesus were always waiting for him to say something they could use against him. By speaking in parables, Jesus was making it very hard for them. He could hardly be arrested for telling them homely stories. So, you know, hinahanapan nila ng butas si Jesus all the time. You know, are you going to speak against the government? Are you going to say something against the religious leaders? Kung meron ka ba sasabihin. So all of his teachings, if you notice, although may mga katuruan siya na laban sa sistema ng buhay, laban sa religious, kasamaan ng religious leaders, pero it was not directly said. It was said through parables. So number one is to give his enemies no ground. In Luke chapter 11, verse 53 hanggang 54, the easy-to-read version, it says, "When Jesus went out, the teachers of the law and the Pharisees began to give him much trouble. They tried to make him answer questions about many things. They were trying to find a way to catch Jesus saying something wrong." So in a parable, yun na talaga na wala naman mali dyan eh, because the lesson is hidden. So that's one reason why Jesus spoke in parables. Number two was to enlighten the true-hearted. To enlighten the true-hearted. Jesus took advantage of occasions when multitudes flocked to hear him speak. Through the parables, he could enlighten those whose hearts were sincere and receptive and who were hungering and thirsting for righteousness. Matthew chapter 5, verse 6, hunger and thirst for righteousness. The parable of the sower illustrates that the seed of God's word grows and bears fruit in good hearts. When he had told this parable, Jesus said, "He who has ears, let him hear." People who tune their ears to the word of God and they understand the truth. Let's go back. To enlighten the true-hearted. So one purpose of a parable is to enlighten those that desire. Kung hindi ka interesado, you will not pick up anything from the parable. If you don't have that desire or that hunger for God, a parable will mean nothing to you. So yun ang isang reason. It's only enticing or it's only appealing to those that love God and are thirsting for righteousness. Number three, it is to make people think. Jesus knew that not everybody would understand or give proper thought to his parables. Some people tune their hearts and ears to God's word, while others deliberately block their ears to God's voice. Yet others neither tune nor block their ears. A parable of the two roads makes people think about where their souls are going and to make the decisions to enter by the narrow gate, lest they be swept with the crowd down the broad way to destruction. Matthew 7, 13, 14. "Enter through the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow the road that leads to life, and only a few find it." So going back, to make people think. So yung mga katuruan niya, yung mga parables, he used it so that you can think. Iisipin mo, ano nga ba talagang sinasabi ni Jesus? You know, it was not spoon-fed to us. Hindi niya ibinibigay sa atin the way it really means. He hid the truth in order for us to seek. Number four, to divide into two. Letter A, after telling the parable of the sower, Jesus was asked by his disciples the question, "Why do you speak to them in parables?" Jesus answered by quoting Isaiah concerning people who have eyes but do not see and have ears but do not hear. In telling the parables, Jesus was bringing pressure to bear upon his listeners to either open their spiritual eyes and ears and be enlightened or to shut their eyes and ears tighter and be condemned. He replied, Matthew 13, 11 to 17, he replied, "Because the knowledge of the secrets of the kingdom of heaven has been given to you, but not to them. Whoever has will be given more, and they will have an abundance. Whoever does not have, even what they have will be taken away from them. This is why I speak to them in parables. Though seeing, they do not see. Though hearing, they do not hear or understand. In them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah. You will be ever hearing but never understanding. You will be ever seeing but never perceiving. For this people's heart has become callous. They hardly hear with their ears, and they have closed their eyes. Otherwise, they might see their eyes, hear their ears, understand with their hearts, and turn, and I would heal them. But blessed are your eyes because they see, and your ears because they hear. For truly, I tell you, many prophets and righteous people long to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it." So one of the purposes is to divide into two. So most of the time, if you notice, yung kanyang mga parables, yung parables ni Jesus, it would split the parang laging merong good and bad. You know, if you have the Good Samaritan, laging merong isang na pinapakita na mabuti, and then the rest are bad. When you read the parable of the sower, it talks about the good soul and the rest are bad. There's always a distinction between good and bad. Yun ang idea that Jesus was trying to bring a distinction between the two. And let us see, the parables not only make people think, they also make people choose. They bring people out of the gray area into the clearly black or white. The parables were a tool for Jesus by which he was able to separate the wheat from the chaff. So yun ang purpose, it was a tool for Jesus to separate those that were for him and not for him. And finally, number five, to fulfill prophecy. Jesus was guided in his ministry by the scriptures of the prophets, where he found his wisdom and authority to speak in parables. Letter B, Jesus spoke to the multitudes in parables, and he was not speaking to them without a parable. So that was so what was spoken by through the prophet might be fulfilled, saying, I will open my mouth in parables. I will utter things hidden since the foundation of the world. That is in Matthew 13, verse 34 to 35. Basahin po natin. Jesus spoke all these things to the crowd in parables. He did not say anything to them without using a parable. So was fulfilled what was spoken through the prophet. I will open my mouth in parables. I will utter things hidden since the creation of the world. So what's happening here is God or Jesus is revealing truths that were hidden since the beginning of the world. So ibig sabihin, bago lahat ito. That's why it wasn't easy for them to understand. Kaya hindi nila kaagad maintindihan. Kasi these were truths that were hidden. Natatago. You know, like the parable of the Good Samaritan. You know, that's not something that they can grasp. Hindi nila maintindihan because they were not supposed to touch. Sa panahon before Jesus, they were not supposed to touch Samaritans. Samaritans and Jews were not supposed to mingle. They were not supposed to talk. They were not supposed to even touch them. So nung sinabi ni Jesus yung the Good Samaritan, it was something foreign to them. Bagong-bago sa kanila. Kaya when you look at the life of Jesus, he was captivating his audience not only by the anointing of God upon his life, but by the stories he told. Bagong-bago. Bagong-bago sa kanila lahat yan. So that's why it was to fulfill prophecy. I will open my mouth in parables. I will utter things hidden since the creation of the world. Purpose of parables. Let's read 23 verses. Better, this is the purpose of parables. Matthew chapter 13, verse 1, hanggang verse 23. That same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat by the lake. Such large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat in it while all the people stood on the shore. Then he told them many things in parables, saying, a farmer went out to sow his seed. As he was scattering the seed, some fell along the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky places where it did not have much soil. It sprang up quickly because the soil was shallow. But when the sun came up, the plants were scorched, and they withered because they had no root. Other seed fell among thorns, which grew up and choked the plants. Still other seed fell on good soil, where it produced a crop, 160 or 30 times what was sown. Whoever has ears, let them hear. The disciples came to him and asked, why do you speak to the people in parables? He replied, because the knowledge of the secrets of the kingdom of heaven has been given to you, but not to them. So ibig sabihin, what we're finding out here, that a parable is a secret revealed to those that have a relationship with God. So the relationship with God comes first. I remember nung hindi pa ako believer, I used to join these poster-making contests when I was in elementary, poster-making contests. And for lack of a better quotation, Lahat, it seemed like everyone that joined during those days was ang sinusulat nila pagka religious yung competition, you'll be fishers of men. Yun lang ang ano eh, yun lang ang everybody was akala mo yun ang pinapagawa ng mga teachers because everybody that would join laging yun, you will become fishers of men. It was because the truth of other parables, truth of other sayings of Jesus, it was hidden from them, kasi from me, kasi I didn't know better. Nakita ko sa kanila, fishers of men. Gaya din ako, fishers of men. Ganun ba rin sa inyo, fishers of men? Ano ba yung sa inyo? Iba-iba na ngayon, ano? That was, mga 6 years ago lang naman yun yung elementary, ha? 60s. Pero talaga, you know, no one knew what it meant. Talaga, walang nakakaalam. Hindi nila alam. You know, we had all of these scriptures and quotations. We tried to create posters relevant. And because it was fishers of men, lahat kami puro mangingisda yung ginawa. Because we didn't understand what it meant. And now I understand na hindi, it has nothing to do with fishing. It's about coming to know the Lord Jesus Christ. Pero noon, hindi ko talaga maintindihan. And, you know, I realize now how our minds as unbelievers are talaga nakatago. Look at verse 11. It says, secrets of the kingdom of heaven has been given to you. It's because they had a relationship with Jesus Christ. That's what the purpose of parables are. It's to, for those that understand God will understand, and for those that don't understand God won't understand. The other night, nanonood ako ng this one program na I love watching, yung Storage Wars. Yung nagsusubasta sila ng mga iba-iba, mga storage. Tapos yung isa, she was able to buy a box full of jewelry. And because she didn't know whether it was real or not, pinasuri niya sa isang expert. And the expert immediately knew what was fake and what was real. And nag-usap kami ni Florence, I was saying, what do they see? You know, ano nakikita ng isang expert in an expert jeweler that we cannot see? You know, sometimes pwede mong pagtabihin parang mas maganda pa kung minsan yung ano eh, yung fake eh, di ba? Naranasan niyo na ba yon? Mas maganda pa yung fake kaysa dun sa totoo. You know, mas elaborate pa yung mga design kung minsan eh. And I was, you know, I'm asking myself, what do they see? Kung walang itatatak na 24 karat gold, walang 21, walang 18, what do you see? What does the expert jeweler see? Ano yung nakikita nila? You know, from a distance, nakikita niya na this is fake, this is real. Ano kaya, di ba iniisip ko yun eh? How is it possible that this man, with just his naked eye, can determine a diamond is real or not? Ibig sabihin, the reason why they know is because they have experience. Diba? It's so madaling-madali sa kanila. That's why this becomes real to me, that the only reason why we understand is because first we understand who the story came from. Kung saan galing yung kwento. And when we understand that, then the kwento in itself becomes easy to understand. Whoever has will given be given more, and they will have an abundance. Whoever does not have, even what they have will be taken from them. The other day, meron po kaming somewhat of an outreach sa Subic, yes, Tuesday, kahapon. And we were talking to, kasama ko si Pastor Arnel and Pastor Jesse, we were talking to this man, kami ni Pastor Jesse, may kausap kaming lalaki. Very well-educated man. In his profession, he's very, you know, sought after by Philippine companies and international companies. Very high salary. And talagang mautak. And we were talking about things of Christianity. And I was so surprised na he was like, ano, parang kausap mo bata. He's clueless about spiritual things. Pero sobrang talino niya. But the things that we understand, just because we understand, just because we know God, minsan we take for granted when you talk to some people, talagang they don't know what's going on. Hindi dahil bobo sila. Because this is a talagang very highly, high educated, very matalino siya. You could tell by the way he speaks. Pero when he was asking us questions, requiring us to give an answer, parang everything was so new to him about the gospel and what's happening in church. Bagong-bago sa kanya. So I realized na talagang whoever has will be given more, verse 12, and they will have an abundance. Whoever does not have, even what they have will be taken from them. So talaga yung the wisdom from God is very different from the wisdom of the world. And we have to understand that that's the purpose of parables. This is why I speak to them in parables, verse 13. Though seeing, they do not see. Though hearing, they do not hear or understand. In them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah. You will be ever hearing but never understanding. You will be ever seeing but never perceiving. For this people's heart has become calloused. They hardly hear with their ears. They have closed their eyes. Otherwise, they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their hearts, and turn, and I would heal them. But blessed are your eyes because you see, and your ears because you hear. Verse 17, for truly I tell you, many prophets and righteous people long to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. Listen then to what the parable of the sower means. When anyone hears the message about the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away what was sown in their heart. This is a seed sown along the path. Verse 20. The seed falling on rocky ground refers to the one, to someone who hears the word and at once receives it with joy. But since they have no root, they last only a short time. When trouble or persecution comes because of the word, they quickly fall away. Verse 22. The seed falling among the thorns refers to someone who hears the word, but the worries of this life and the deceitfulness of wealth choke the word, making it unfruitful. But the seed falling on good soil refers to someone who hears the word and understands it. This is the one who produces a crop yielding 100, 60, or 30 times what was sown. So this is the parable na first nababasahin natin. Kasi in this parable, we find the purpose of the parable. Sa loob ng parable of the sower, we'll find the reason behind why Jesus speaks in parables. Actually, based on history, this is the first parable na sinalita ni Jesus. And then there are 50 or more over after this. Let's have a recap as we come to an end. Why did Jesus speak in parables? Number one, to give his enemies no ground. Number two, to enlighten the true-hearted. Number three, to make people think. Number four, to divide into two. And number five, it was prophesied that he would speak that way. That's why you notice in the Bible, wala nang iba na tumulad sa kanya that spoke in parables. It was prophesied that he would speak. That was one of his traits, to speak in parables. And it was very... Jesus was a very crafty teacher. And next Wednesday, I'm excited because the parable of the sower, there's so much to learn from the parable of the sower. Yung mga things that we've learned before, we'll relearn. Pero I guarantee you that we'll learn some new things about the parable of the sower. So join us on Wednesday night for ano yung gagawin ng Panginoon. Amen po. Don't forget, on Sunday the 25th, join us. Services will be both in the morning and evening. We'll have a few songs from some people in the church as well. Pero, of course, there'll be the preaching of the gospel. Amen po. By the way, Pastor Jesse and yung iba, Margie, Marlon, Erica, and then, of course, the Lakbayan family is in here kasi ikinasal po yung kanilang sister. So they're all at, ngayon kumakain na sila, kainggit naman. So lahat sila ay kumakain na ngayon. Everybody, please join me. Please stand and let us pray. By the way, yung kanina, di ba, I asked you to please stand and let us pray. Yesterday, we were at the jail. Kapag meron tumayo, nasabi, let us pray, automatic, tatayo sila. You don't even have to, tayong mga Kristiyano sa church, medyo iba-iba pa tayo, you know? over there, nagulat ako eh, magsipanalangin po tayo, tayuan silang lahat. There were, how many hundred were nakaupo doon? About 150, 200? And then there were, the rest of the thousand was inside. Pag sinabi mo, let's pray, tayo, wala nang ngiting-ngiti, serious ka agad. So, we've learned a lot, we've learned a lot. Actually, mas disiplinado pa sila sa atin eh. Pagbango nila, let me just close with this. After the meeting, when they all stood up, tapos na, uwian na kami, they stood up, picked up their chairs, picked up their kalat. They were more, sorry to say, more disciplined than most of us are. But talaga, you know, so we have a lot to learn from them, from the way their lifestyle even. So let us pray. Nahanga lang ako sa disiplina nila. Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you for blessing us, allowing us to be present in this place tonight and to pray to you. This is an honor para sa amin, Panginoon, that we can talk to you and pray to you any time of the day. Salamat po. And that we're not just talking to you, but you are actually listening and hearing. At tumutugon po kayo sa aming mga dalangin. Tonight, Father, as we leave this place, protect all of us, Panginoon, as we go home. And for those that will be traveling sa kanilang mga provinces during this week, Lord, let your divine protection be upon all of the families that will be traveling, Lord. Salamat po, Jesus. We lift up our service this coming Sunday again. Let your anointing, let your blessing be upon the people that will come and on the word that will be preached. Salamat po, Jesus. We give you praise tonight in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Thank you for coming, everyone. God bless.